okay. We've sent out resumes and we should just expect those interview invitations to come pouring in. Please. Soba, you have the most recent interview experience. Give us some good tips.
Oh yeah, I had so many interviews. I'm like a professional candidate now. But thank goodness for the online interviewing tool at ACS. That helped me build and strengthen my interview skills. And I practiced with my ACS career consultant over the phone, which helped me jump through all those hoops from the first phone call to the second call. And
what? Jumping through hoops?
Yeah, three interviews. First, there was the HR guy. That was like half an hour. And then I had a phone interview with the manager, but that was only the beginning. Okay, and then finally, I had the whole panel interview thing with like five people. It was so intimidating. Like one of the guys holds like 60 patents. I looked it up, and they ask you all kind of questions that you don't want to answer. Dude, it's not that bad. You know, there's just questions about how you handled some awful mess you got into, or what happens when you missed a deadline, or went over budget. Anyway, I told the story about how last summer, my project generated this fantastic PR challenge when all the test subjects escaped from their cages due to an animal testing protester infiltrating the lab, and I guess they were just like fascinated with the story. Because
what kind of questions did they ask?
You know, the usual stuff.
Neil, panel interviews aren't that bad. I've served on them myself. We ask behavioral questions because it helps us to compare technical competence, what motivates you, how you solve problems, and how you'd fit in our culture. If you survive the resume scrub and the preliminary phone interview, then that means you are a serious candidate. We want you to succeed.
Doc, it's been ages since I've faced interviewers. How do I even prepare for that?
Oh, I think you know. Think about what they may ask and practice answering. Maybe have a friend help you over a cup of coffee.
But Doc, what kind of questions do we practice with?
Oh, that's easy. Just think of the worst thing that ever happened in your entire career and explain how you handled it and what good came from it.
Oh, no, no, you gotta be kidding.
Not that. Oh, not the worst.
What's the matter? Haven't had your caffeine today?
Wah, who called the wambulance? Get a grip, will ya?
Okay, help us. Help us. We need help.
I meant get a grip on yourself.
They need to prepare for the interview. You and I can be the panel.
Ooh, sounds like fun. I always wanted to be an interrogator.
Doc, you two know each other?
Come. It's my coffee cup, isn't it? Now, let's focus on getting you a job, shall we? Dr. Caffeine, after you.
Why, yes. Thank you, Dr. Albright. So, Null, so tell me about a time when your biochemical materials posed a serious health threat.
What? How'd you know about that?
Pathetically unprepared and naive.
Maybe that's a little severe. How about telling us how you managed the situation?
Anytime I'm working with active enzymes, even those which are considered beneficial, I treat them as a potentially hazardous materials. For example, hygiene and waste management are critically important, and I explain things to the new lab technicians, like ecological threats in the water supply and proper disposal. We did have a really serious, horrendous problem once when I was out of the lab, but since I had posted emergency actions in advance, the problem was contained, and
You could say you mitigated the threat and continued monitoring just in case of latent effects.
That's right, which there weren't any. We successfully contained the problem.
Prepared for problem and successfully contained.
Okay, now you, Gwen.
Describe a time when a teammate's actions nearly brought your research to a screeching halt and drove your employer bankrupt! How did you manage the situation?
Okay, that never happened to me.
Then describe your own situation that fits the context of the question.
Okay, this is about leadership and management skills. I manage diverse teams of varying skill levels. One time, a junior technician took it upon himself to run multiple trials using the same tech batch material, thinking it would save us time. Because I had rigid documentation practices in place and I review project status daily, I discovered the problem within 24 hours and was able to discard the duplicate information.
Checks and balances. Interesting.
I corrected the technician privately and paired him with a mentor.
Staff development.
And I also reviewed the correct testing process with the entire team and introduced additional batch notations in the documentation process.
Process improvement. Bravo! Bravo!
Good risk management, especially being able to catch it so quickly. Now, describe a mistake you once made and how you handled it.
I'd like to think I'm a very good scientist, but there are things I would do different now.
Maybe it's not a scientific mistake.
Maybe it was hiring that moron bench technician in the first place.
Oh, I inherited the team when the first supervisor left.
So what happens when we hire you to manage our team? Are you going to risk making the same mistake?
I didn't hire the guy.
And you had no idea of his capabilities when you were supervising him.
I should have interviewed everyone when I came on board, learned their skills, reviewed the process with them to make sure we're all on the same page.
Now describe that in a way that will make us hire you anyway.
Right. One time, when I took over a research team, I made the mistake of thinking they all understood the correct scientific process to follow, only to discover that one of them would make a mistake later. Now, when I take over a team, I plan to interview every member so that I know their skills and training, and review our process with the team.
And now back to the dude.
Huh?
What would you say is your greatest weakness?
I don't know what to say.
Why is it that you hate your father?
What?
Okay, panics easily.
No. Look, I have no weaknesses. I'm a strong candidate for whatever this job is.
We have ways of making you talk.
Okay. My greatest weakness is probably my lack of experience. In business, that is, naturally.
You're right, and you're out of here. Next!
No, wait! I've been involved in some leading-edge research already, and what I know can help your company develop new products.
Really?
Pretty good, eh?
All right, my boy. You hit it right out of the park. I like you. Maybe we'll let you play on our team. Do you have any questions for us?
Ting. Oh, shucks, coach. It weren't nothing. Can I have the job?
Don't ask that. Be serious. What do you need to know about the company?
Okay, how much do they pay?
Nothing if we don't hire you. Dude, I'll give you a hint. Ask questions that, make your interviewers believe that you actually researched the company a little and that you like us. You really like us.
And remember your values.
Yeah, remember, this is the time when you are interviewing us. How do we, the employer, fit with your values and goals?
Oh, I see. The tables are turned, huh? Okay, so what's your market share in enzyme-assisted pharmaceuticals? Do you see your R&D budget growing in that area in light of the growth in enzyme deficiency diagnoses?
Ooh, the market share question. I like that.
The body language is all wrong.
Okay, here, let me help. How's this for body language?
Be confident, but respectful, like you're already part of the team.
Yeah, part of the team already. What's up, my man?
Don't take it too far.
He's trying to save you from yourself, dude.
Okay, so does your culture provide opportunities to collaborate across teams? What are the key qualities I need to succeed? And what is your competitive edge, considering that your staff is smaller than others in this field?
Hey, way to go! Now you're talking!
Oh, yeah.
That's it! Oh, wonderful
oh,
job!
Yeah, you're the
oh,
man.
Yes, I am very impressed. Oh, yeah. I will hire you right away. I wish I had had that interview.
I wonder.
I'm Decaf. What's your name?
Gosh.